Students, how are you all? Welcome to computer class. Today we will continue our first chapter, number system. But before that, let's recall the things that we did learned in our previous video. In our previous video, we did learned about decimal number system. As we know, the decimal number system is used in our mathematical calculation. The number system we using is a decimal number system. Decimal number system consists of 10 digits. They are 0 to 9. Hence, the base of decimal number system is 10. And least significant digit. In any given number, the last digit in any given number, the last digit is called least significant digit. Next one is most significant digit. In any given number, the first digit in any given number, the first digit is called most significant digit. Today we are going to learn about binary number system. So let's start with binary number system. The binary number system consists of two digits. Binary number system consists of two digits, that is 0 and 1. Two digits are 0 and 1. Hence, the base of binary number system is 2. Because here in binary number system, we are using only two digits, 0 and 1. See students, in our decimal number system, we are using 10 digits, 0 to 9. So they are total 10 digits. So in decimal number system, the base of number system is 10. But in binary number system, we are using two digits, 0 and 1. So the base of our binary number system is 2. The language understood by a computer is the binary language. The language understood by a computer is a binary language. As we know, our computer understands only and only in binary language. It means it understands only in 0 and 1. Therefore, the instruction given to a computer are converted into the binary language. Therefore, the instruction, whatever the instruction we are given to a computer, they are converted into the binary language. For example, when we visit the outside of our native place, sometimes the languages are changed. So that time we need one converter that can convert our language into the opposite side person's language. Same time, our operating system does the same work. It converts the English language, the instruction we are given in English language. So it converts the instructions in binary language. So our computer understands in binary language. Now let's look an example. Today we will learn to convert binary number system in a decimal number. So here I have one number, 101. Now, as previously we did, in our decimal number system, we having place value, means 1's place, 10's place, 100 place. It means 10 raised to 0's place, 10 raised to 1's place, 10 raised to 2's place. Same way, here we also having a base table. Because the base of our binary number system is 2, so here we having 2 raised to 0's place, 2 raised to 1 place, and 2 raised to 2's place. So let's start with least significant digit. So I put last significant digit at 2 raised to 0 place. I put 0 at 2 raised to 1 place and I put most significant digit at 2 raised to 2 place. Now let's multiply the value with its base table value. So let's take 1 and multiply it with 2 raised to 0. 2 raised to 0 or any number raised to 0 equal to 1. Remember one thing, if any number raised to 0, if it is 2 raised to 0, 5 raised to 0, 7 raised to 0 or 10 raised to 0, it becomes 1. So 1 multiplied by 2 raised to 0, it means 1 multiplied by 1 equal to 1. Now let's take second digit, 0 multiplied by 2 raised to 1. So 0 multiplied by 2 raised to 1 means 2. Any number raised to 1 means the number itself. Any number raised to 1 means number itself. If it is 5 raised to 1, it means 5. It is 10 raised to 1, then 10. So 0 multiplied by 2, it means 0. Now let's take most significant digit, means first number 1, and multiply by its base value, it is 2 raised to 2. So 1 multiply by 2 raised to 2 means 2 raised to 2 means 4. So 1 multiply by 4. 2 raised to 2 means 2 multiply by 2 times. So 2 raised to 2 equal to 4. Now add up all the numbers. 4 plus 1 equal to 5. So it is our, we find the answer in the decimal number. So it is 5, it is our decimal number. So when we put 5 in a computer, operating system translate in the binary number 101. This process done by our operating system. So let's learn the base table of binary number system. 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3. See, when we are moving to the previous digit, 1 power is increment. 2 raised to 5, 2 raised to 6, 2 raised to 7. Now 2 raised to 0 means 1, 2 raised to 1 means 2, 2 raised to 2 means 4, 2 raised to 3 means 8, 2 raised to 4 means 16, 2 raised to 5 means 32, 2 raised to 6 means 64, and 2 raised to 7 means 128. So please try to remember this base table so you can convert any binary number into decimal very easily. Now let's convert the decimal number system to a binary number system. Let's convert decimal number system into a binary number system. Decimal to binary conversion. So here we having decimal number 25. How can I identify the decimal number? Because you can see in 25 we having a base 10. Base 10 means decimal number. So we have to convert decimal number into a binary. So how can we identify we have to convert in binary? Because we have put base 2. So let's start the conversion. So first step, take your number. Step 1, divide the given number by 2. So we'll divide our number 25 by 2. So 12 twos are 24. Okay, 12 twos are 24. Now 25 minus 24, so what will be the remainder? 1. Yes, so write down the remainder and divide the quotient again by 2. So here I put my remainder 1 and again I got the quotient 12. So again I divide the quotient by 2. So 2. The steps are repeated till the quotient become 0 or 1. Step we will going to repeat this step dividing by 2 until the quotient becomes 0 or 1. So let's do the step. First we will divide 25 by 2. So 2 12s are 25. Here I wrote the quotient, not the number. Remember, here I wrote the quotient. 12 2s are 24. Now 25 minus 24, so remainder we got 1. Again we will repeat the step. 2 divided by 12 means 12 6 are 2. 2 6 are 12. 12 minus 12, so we got remainder 0. Again we divide the quotient means 6 by 2. So 12 3 is 6. Sorry, 2 3 is 6. And 6 minus 6, remainder we got 0. Again, we'll repeat the step because here we haven't got 0 or 1. So we'll repeat the step again. 2 1s are 2. 2 1s are 2. Now 3 minus 2, so we got the remainder 1. Now here we have to stop because we got the quotient 1. Now let's write the number, but remember one thing, we have to take the quotient also. So we have to write the number, okay, from down to up format. So let's write the number. So 25 base 10 equal to, let's start with the bottom to upside. So 11001. The answer of 25 base 10 equal to, when we convert this 25 number in binary, we got the answer 11001. Now let's take in another example. So here we have number 16. We can easily identify because 16 have base 10. Now let's convert in binary number. So take your number, okay, again divide the given number by 2. So we'll divide 16 by 2. So 2 8s are 16. 2 8s are, see here I wrote the quotients, okay, not a number. So 2 8s are 16. Now write down the remainder and divide the quotients again by 2. We have to repeat, okay, so write down the remainder. 2 8s are 16. 16 minus 16 equal to 0. So here I wrote the remainder 0. Now the steps are repeated till the quotient becomes 0 or 1. We have to repeat the steps until the quotient becomes 0 and 1. So let's start doing. So let's repeat the step again. I take the 16 and divide by 2. So 2 8s are 16 and 16 minus 16, remainder is 0. Again divide by 2. So 2 4s are 8, 8 minus 8, remainder is 0. Again divide by 2. 2 2s are 4, 2 2s are 4, 4 minus 4, so remainder is 0. Now again repeat the step. 2 1s are 2, 2 1s are 2, and 2 minus 2, remainder is 0. Now we have to stop because we got the quotient 1. So we have to stop here. Now, we'll, as I say, we'll take the number from bottom to upside. So when we convert decimal number 16, we got the number 10000. So it is our answer. Now I have some exercise for you. So write down these numbers, solve this exercise, take a photograph of your homework and send it to me. That's it for today, students. Thank you.